Right, John, as the overdose crisis continues to impact families and communities across the country, some lawmakers in Harrisburg are looking to build upon efforts to fight the epidemic.
There's a measure that requires the mapping of overdoses across Pennsylvania. That was signed into law last year. But today, Erie News Now State Capitol correspondent Brendan Scanlon learned more about its impact. So Brendan is joining us live from Harrisburg tonight. What can you tell us about this mapping overdose?
Hey there, Mike and Eva. Good evening. So today we heard from lawmakers, law enforcement, and family members who have lost loved ones. They say it's time to get in front of this crisis, and they say that mapping overdoses across Pennsylvania is a step toward doing just that.
It always seems like we're on the defense. We're always reacting. We got to get ahead of these problems. I'm tired of reacting and hearing of losses like Tyler and Chambersburg, and you know, we're always reacting. Why can't we get ahead of it?
Legislation sponsored by State Senator Doug Mastriano to map overdoses was signed into law by Governor Wolf in 2022.
This new law requires law enforcement officers to input data into a statewide overdose information system within 72 hours after encountering a known or suspected overdose.
Mastriano says Act 158, which went into effect in January, was designed with one purpose.
It's a noble cause and a design. And the desire, of course, is that it saves lives.
Law enforcement say mapping is providing a clearer picture of drug trends across the Commonwealth.
Fentanyl clearly is the number one killer, and now we have the xylazine that's adding to the issues.
Jerry Daly, the executive director of the Liberty Mid-Atlantic High Intensity Drug Trafficking Area, or HIDA, says the mapping helps local officials identify emerging trends, mobilize an emergency response, and alert first responders to the existence of fentanyl-laced drugs in a specific region.
Get them where the need is greater so that we can reach more people, divert them into treatment, and get them off of these substances.
And now Senator Mastriano and law enforcement say that although this is a step in the right direction, there is still much more that needs to be done. We'll have many more details about this new law up on our website, erienewsnow.com. But for now, reporting live at the state capitol, I'm Brendan Scanlon. Mike and Eva, back to you.